Here's the deal. We might not notice it, but we're witnessing a massive change in space industry right now. It's not that fast, but it will revolutionize the landscape and allow a completely new path for a lot of companies and startups. And the game changer here is space tourism. And even though it might not seem that important at first, but trust me, the impact of it will be huge. So how is it gonna happen? Well, let's figure this out. At this point, a lot of you might be skeptical. I mean, isn't space tourism just another toy for really rich guys to play with? Does it really have to do anything with actual space exploration? I mean, sure, they do use rockets and capsules to fly for a while, but how is it gonna change things around exactly? And to some extent, you might be correct. At the moment, space tourism doesn't really look like a lot. The whole thing properly started only in 2021. Yes, technically there were space tourists before that who flew to the ISS on Soyuz spacecrafts since 2001, but it was only 7 flights with only 6 people. Now we have 2 main branches of operations. First is suborbital space tourism. This is where Blue Origin's New Shepard and Virgin Galactic spaceship 2 live. They provide a relatively short-term flight, which takes its customers to space for several minutes and then goes back to Earth. It might not sound that exciting, but it lets you see the darkness of space and the curvature of the Earth in the windows and to fly in the weightlessness for a little while, doing all sorts of somersaults. The second branch is much bigger though. It goes to the orbit and possibly beyond. There, clients can go to the ISS and hang out there for several days. This is what Axiom Space and others are offering as a service. Or they can stay in the Crew Dragon capsule for several days and come back to Earth without docking to anything. This is what SpaceX are doing at the moment. This sounds much more exciting, for obvious reasons, but at the same time it's several orders of magnitude more expensive. For example, taking a ride on a New Shepard should eventually cost you several hundred grand. So it's in the ballpark of getting an expensive premium car. Whereas a seat on a Crew Dragon going to orbit should cost tens of millions of dollars. That's like buying an expensive premium house instead of a car. So taking into account the current state of the industry, how on earth is it going to change space exploration? Well, I believe that the main thing about that is that space tourism can be an independent source of income from private space companies like SpaceX, Blue Origin, Virgin, and many others who will get themselves involved in the food chain. Up until now, space was absolutely dominated by governments. They were the only ones who could afford to go there and do something meaningful. This meant that the entire space industry was solely reliant on what the governments were willing to spend on. Now, things start to change. We can see the rise of private companies that can attract capital by providing their services independently of the government agencies. Of course, all the flights are very much regulated by guys like NASA, but still it's a source of income for SpaceX and others. And because an opportunity to fly into space is definitely an exclusive product, which has a much greater demand than there is supply for it, it means that companies will be able to charge premium for that. And that means that having this additional cash flow, they will be able to invest in their new projects like rockets, spaceships, orbital stations, moon bases, you name it. What the space industry has been building so far is infrastructure that allows a reliable and relatively affordable access to space. We are now at the point where people can actually start using it. If you imagine space being like a deserted place on Earth, then to establish something there, first you need to build a road, a power grid, and other crucial infrastructure elements. This is a very expensive and resource-hungry thing to do, which really only governments can take the burden of. But once the road is built, you'll see hotels, restaurants, and other things like that emerge. Those are the things that create new markets and start the economy going in the area. And this is exactly the point we're at with space industry today. Space tourism is one of the most obvious things that can be a foundation to a free economy in space. We have new ships being developed, we have new space stations being planned, like the Axiom station that's supposed to be a part of the ISS at first and then separate, or a project called Orbital Reef by Blue Origin, Boeing and Sierra Space, and lots of others. And all this doesn't need to stop just at tourism. Like for example, why not build a sports arena in space? Imagine like a real-life medicine cube garden flying around. Maybe they'll even create whole new sport disciplines that will take advantage of weightlessness or adopt existing ones. Like imagine how cool it would be to, let's say, have a Formula One Grand Prix on the moon or Space Champions League football competition. Yes, things like that are mainly focused on entertainment, and you might think they're not serious enough to propel space exploration. But in my opinion, that is wrong. Just look at what we have today. A lot of science breakthroughs are in fact backed by entertainment. Industries like movies and games that generate a lot of income act as engines for a lot of research in the computer industry. A lot of tech is developed for sports and more. You also need to consider the fact that space infrastructure is getting cheaper and more reliable. 5 years ago, it would be really hard to imagine a mission like Inspiration 4 that would carry civilians with no previous flight experience to space. In another 5 years, we might see another transformation with projects like Starship, which can make it really ordinary to put tens of people in space on a single launch. And this is exactly what space tourism can create demand for. Without private initiatives, everything will go much slower, as even NASA, the richest space agency out there, doesn't really need hundreds of people in space. So it's not just about the money and independent cash flow, it's also about setting independent targets. Before that, all manned space flight was guided by space agencies and their needs. And it was the only thing that any solutions were developed for. But once there is other demand, the range and variety of solutions will massively expand. The range of businesses that can get involved will also get much bigger. Whole new industries can be created that will operate in space. The ones that are not controlled and ordered by the governments in any way. And I believe this can be a vastly more important factor that will shape the entire space industry in the nearest future than almost anything else. So by allowing space tourism to start as a proper industry, we'll be opening the gates to an entire new world of possibilities. Thus, we should definitely not underestimate it and not treat it as just another toy for billionaires. But if you have any other opinions on that, don't be shy and let me know that in the comments. I think that can be a really good discussion. Don't forget to like and share if you enjoyed the video, or dislike if you didn't. You can support us on Patreon if you like what we do, but most importantly, stay curious, my friends.